Hi, this is Big Data Guy, and welcome to my Spark tutorial series. In this series, our aim is to learn by doing. So what we are going to be doing is working on a project to analyze stock market data. So let's get started. So I have stock data, and I'm going to be uploading this on GitHub. So please check out the description to get the link to this data set. So this is a very simple data set that I've downloaded from internet, and it contains ticker, date, and then the closing price of the stock, volume, open, high, and low for a particular date. So in this case, this data is about Apple, and then I have the information about probably 10 most popular stocks on the NYSE, along with the popular indexes like QQQ and SPY. So anyways, so let's get started. We have the data in CSV format, and we are going to be analyzing the stock data using Spark in order to learn Spark. So yeah, so the first thing is that we are going to go and start Jupyter Notebook. So navigate to the folder. In this case, I already navigated to the Spark tutorial, and I'm just going to execute Jupyter Notebook command in order to start the notebook. So my notebook has started. And it should give me this basic Spark DF tutorial notebook. And I'm going to be publishing that notebook on the GitHub as well. So you can go and access this. And I have a variety of operations listed over here that we are going to go ahead and try to learn by analyzing the stock price data. So let's get started. So what we are going to be doing is we are going to be focusing on reading and cleaning the stock price data in section one. In section two, we are going to go and do the basic stock analysis. Then we are going to focus on join, advanced analysis, and saving data. So the objective is that we are going to look at a real world data and a real world problem and pretty much learn by doing, right? So we are going to be analyzing the stock price data just by doing a variety of Spark functions. So let's get started. So the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to go and create Spark session. And we already covered this last time. So I'm quickly going to import the files that we need. So import PySpark. And then we are going to import PySpark.sql import Spark session. All right. So this is going to, this is actually from. So this is going to allow us to create PySpark session. So let's go ahead and create our PySpark session. So in order to create Spark session, we are going to simply write a Spark session dot builder dot app name. You could name your app anything. In this case, we are going to say stock price analysis, because that's what we are going to be doing, and get or create. And once you do this, we have a Spark session initiated. And then once the Spark session has been initiated, we can go ahead and read the file. So in this case, because we are reading a CSV file, all I need to do is that I need to say spark.read.csv and specify the path where these files are located at, right? So you can read one CSV file or you can read a folder together. So in this case, we're going to go ahead and read a folder. So as you can see, I have the data in the same folder where my notebook resides in. So stock data folder is in the same location as my notebook. So I can just say that go and read the data from stock data. And I can execute this. Again, just to remind you from last time, shortcut to execute the cell is shift enter. So, okay, so the data has been read into a data frame, right? So now we can go ahead and see the data. So we already finished reading the data. Now let's go and see the data, what we have. So let's actually move this under reading the CSV data. And we already read that, right? So we're just gonna reread the data once again. And then I'm going to go ahead and see the data. So in order to see the data, I just need to say stocks.show, right? So stocks is our data frame name, and then show is to show. So notice when we read the data, what has happened is that our headers have become the first row, and then the columns have been, column names have been C0, C1, C2, and so on, right? So we need to tell Spark when it's reading data that, hey, you know what, when you read the data, actually I already have headers for you, right? So, you know, please consider the first column as headers, and it's going to go ahead and do that, right? So now you can see that the headers are being considered when you read the data, right? Now we can go and see the schema of the data. So schema is we want to figure out, you know, what type of columns, what data type is associated with each of the columns. So, you know, with ticker, it would be string. With date, it should be date, but it doesn't look like it is going to be date, and then so on, right? So let's look at the data types in this data frame. So when you look at that, and I can say print schema to look at the data types in the data frame. And as you can see, there is ticker, there is date, and all of those are basically string data type, right? So what we want to be able to do is we want to be able to convert some of this data type to an integer or a float in order to do some manipulation, right? So if you want to figure out what's the average open price for BRKB or Microsoft in this year, then I need this data in integer or float format in order to calculate average. Currently, it's in string format. So we're going to go and change that pretty soon. But before we do that, what we want to do is we want to be able to select some columns from this data frame, right? So there is two different ways that you could actually select columns. So what we can do is write the data frame name, which is stocks, then write select, stocks.select, because from that's the data frame from where we want to select the column from, and then write the column name. So in this case, I want to select ticker, and then I only want to see three values. Then I can say, you know, show three, and then it's only going to show me top three values from this particular column, which is BRKB, right? Similarly, you might want to select multiple values from the data frame. So how do I do that? It's pretty simple. All you need to do is just create a list. So you can say stocks.select and then write it in list. I can say ticker, comma, you know, date, comma, open, right? So this is what I wanna see. And I can say, show me the first five value from these three columns, and it is going to show me the first five values from this three column. Cool. So this is a very basic way to select the columns from data frame. Now we can go and, you know, see how we can filter the values from the data frame, how we can select particular rows from the data frame, right? So in order to do that, all we need to do is use filter command, and that is simple, just like, you know, all you need to do is select the data frames, in this case stocks.filter, and then how do you want to filter this, right? So I can say, okay, I want stocks.ticker. So this is the second way in which you can select the column, stocks.ticker. So now you've selected a column, and I can say, wherever the stock.ticker is equal to Microsoft, go and select those rows, right? So I only want the stock price for Microsoft. And I can say, okay, go and show me, you know, top 10 values from the ticker Microsoft, and I can go and show you the most 10 recent values from Microsoft. And this is what we have. And we can go and, you know, actually do advanced filtering. So we could have multiple conditions as well. So in order to do multiple conditions, it's simple. You just use the AND or operation to do the multiple conditions, right? So I can say, okay, go ahead and show me the stock price for Microsoft on May 31st, 2023, right? So in order to do that, I can say stocks.filter, stocks.ticker is equal to MSFT, which is our Microsoft stock. And then say AND. So the way that you say AND in Spark is use this ampersand. And then once you do that, again, I can say stocks.date equals to 05/31/2023. Right, and then I can say show file, and then when I do that, it only has one value, so it's only going to show you one value, right? On the May 31st, 2023, price of Microsoft was $328. Now, similarly, I can go ahead and say that, okay, I wanna see the stock price for Microsoft and Visa together, right? So how do I do that? And the answer is simple. You can pretty much write or conditions in the middle. And this is actually very important. You need to specify brackets over here. If you don't specify brackets, then you might get an error. So make sure that you specify different conditions using parentheses. Like, so, you know, you can group them together. And I like to keep it this way so that your code looks clean and you know that, you know, where the condition starts and where the condition ends. You don't get into a situation where you get some sort of like, you know, logical error wherein, you know, the filtering happens, but it's just not right type of filtering because you forgot a parenthesis somewhere or something like that, right? So you want to make sure that, you know, it's actually done properly. So I'll give you an example. For example, if I don't write parentheses and I pretty much say that, you know what, show me the stock ticker for Microsoft and also stock for Visa, right, which is the V, ticker for Visa is V. And I say, okay, show me the, you know, top 15 values from this. I messed up somewhere. So let's, it should be double equal over here. So as you can see that, you know, now you have the, you know, stock price from Microsoft, and it doesn't even show Visa because we are only seeing like 15 values, but you can see like, you know, it's not satisfying this condition where the date should be like 31. So it's very important that you actually keep both of these parentheses to make sure that, you know, first it goes and evaluates this condition, and then, you know, it does end condition on top of this condition, right? So I can go and say, okay, go ahead and display me this. And all of a sudden you only have like two values that actually make sense, right? So this is how you can do and or operation. And there's also another operation that is actually important when you're filtering the data. And that is, let's say you want all the values that are actually part of a particular list, right? So you want to display all the stocks price on a particular date. Well, not all the stocks, but, you know, the stocks that are within a particular list, you want to display their price. How do you do that? And the answer is simple. All you do is you say stock ticker dot isin, right? So when you say isin, it actually gives you a list, and then you can say, okay, whatever is, you know, inside this list, you go and display the stock price for that. So I can say Microsoft, QQQ, SPY, and Visa, and then also let's say Tesla, right? And then I can go and display their price for 31st of May, and this is what we have as their different prices, right? And interestingly, you can see that this data is actually dirty because you have some float numbers and you have some, you know, string values and so on, right? And most of these values, all the columns are actually of string type. So when you're actually analyzing the data, you want to make sure that the values are uniform in the data frame. They're actually clean and you can, you know, interact with them properly. So you want to be able to clean out all these values that are actually, you know, not uniform, right, in a column. And we are going to be covering about that in next video. So we are going to talk about how to change the data type and process the data frame using user-defined function. So see you in the next video. Thank you. Bye.